Late Thursday night, Miami-Dade County Commission gave an initial approval to Mayor Carlos Gimenez's $6.8 billion county budget, but not without criticism from environmentalists concerned that climate change is not a priority. Then there is another criticism. One commissioner launched television ads criticizing Mayor Gimenez for transferring desperately needed transportation funds to finance other projects. Joining me to discuss this and more, we welcome Miami-Dade County Commissioner Xavier Suarez, representing District 7. Commissioner, good to have you back.
Thank you for inviting me.
So why now? Why are you launching these ads at this point in time, criticizing the mayor for using more than $100 million to general funds?
It is budget season. We have two hearings. One yesterday, by the way, we ended very late, so I'm a little bit groggy from yesterday, and then one on the 17th. My ads will be running during that 14-day span and reminding my colleagues on the commission, reminding the mayor that we've got to make decisions that are different from what we've been doing for the last 4 years. We cannot have business as usual. Business as usual right now in the county means there's congestion everywhere. There is a slowdown of the business activity of our county. Well, we have a totally inadequate system of mass transportation in Dade County. It has two branches. It needs at least five. I've proposed four additional linkages. And the Citizens Independent Transportation Trust, a famous People's Transportation Plan, the people who are implementing that, are totally in support of my concept, which is $100 million should be given back to the PTP to build those additional linkages, one to South Dade, one to Miami Beach, which is called Bay Link, one to West Dade.
We're talking about light rail.
Light rail, in some cases at grade, you know, like little street cars, and in other cases using existing rail. The rail reactivation study and plan of the county has been in place since 2004.
Okay, so what's going on? So money is being taken out of the half-cent tax that was approved in 2002 by voters.
Correct.
Has not been going, first of all, it overpromised what it could do, number one. And number two, now the monies are used to general funds to finance other projects. Everybody recognizes that transportation is a critical issue. I believe every poll shows that it's the biggest angst residents have in Miami-Dade County. Why isn't there the political will to get the job solved? Is it because it's too expensive? Is it because it's really not feasible? Is it because people are saying Miami-Dade Countyans really are just in love with cars?
There's no leadership. What we do is we meet together, the MPO, the Metropolitan Planning Organization, which is mostly county commissioners and mayors of other cities, and they tell us, the consultants come in and they say, your needs assessment is $13 billion and your sources of funding are zero. Well, great, thank you. Okay, what do we do now? My plan is a very concrete plan. It's received the endorsement of the Miami Herald, an editorial board endorsement, and it says take that money, that $100 million that we're now using to operate Metro-Dade, substitute that, Metro Transit, substitute that with general funds. We have, that's 2.5% of our budget. Anyone can find 2.5% in surplus funds and inefficiencies in our system. We have inefficiencies everywhere, you know, and Mayor Gimenez has not really made any major changes in the bureaucracy of Dade County. He says, you know, this is an elephant, and how do you eat an elephant? One bite at a time. He keeps saying that. Well, let me tell you something. The elephant has begun to eat him instead of the other way around.
But what about the county commission's responsibility? Because the mayor is an administrator,
well,
but you
yes.
are legislative.
Yes. And
so the legislative body has done nothing to solve this problem.
Well, Chairman Bovo, he's the chairman of transportation, mobility and transportation, and I'm a member of that committee. He and I had a sunshine meeting right away as soon as we were both appointed. I suggested that we, at the very least, begin the process of weaning the people's transportation money away, the half cent sales tax away, and putting it back into the capital projects that we need, these additions to the Metro Rail system. And Bovo, Chairman Bovo, agreed to do that over 5 years at $18 million a year. Well, he also said, and I really admire his chutzpah in this, that we needed to, by the end of his 2-year term and my 2-year term as a member of that committee, when we all have to face re-election, by the way, we needed to complete at least one project. Well, as of yesterday, Thursday, it doesn't look like the mayor is ready to begin funding this for at least 5 years. Commissioner Bobo yesterday, Chairman Bobo said, well, you know, I'd like to do this at least 4 years from now. Representative Keani McGee has said we have to complete the linkage to South Dade within 3 years. And that's the way I look at it. I look at it that we have to begin doing it next year using the PTP money, taking it from operations where we have a huge budget, $4.8 billion, where we can find 2% of that budget to use for operations of the system, not reducing a single bus route or a single metro rail system, and instead it applying that. That's $100 million that produces maybe $1.2, $1.3 billion. The rest of the funding is also easy. Again, Representative McGee has taken the leadership.
And Representative McGee is?
He's a representative from South Dade in the State House. He has said, let's take money from MDX. You're going to have a guest coming up pretty soon, the new chairman of MDX. Ask him about that. Ask him about the $130 million that they're taking in toll monies in an urban area where we shouldn't have tolls at all. And their debt service, I believe, is $62 million.
Now, you're very critical of Mayor Gimenez. And Mayor Gimenez spokesman Michael Hernandez said, in an article by Michael Vasquez, of the Miami Herald, governing is a serious business, Hernandez said in a statement. Demagoguery is not. And sadly, that is exactly what Commissioner Suarez's proposal is.
You know, I like Michael Hernandez. He's a nice gentleman, and he knows his craft. Mayor Gimenez, frankly, is using him as a sort of political pit bull, and that's not appropriate. If he's going to be the mayor's spokesperson, he should be a lot more careful in how he accuses me of being a demagogue. I've been in office or running for office or involved in government and civic affairs for 30-some years in Dade County. I not only don't lie ever, I don't exaggerate. I'm an engineer by training. I later became a lawyer and a politician, and you know, And lawyers and politicians tend to exaggerate a lot. But as an engineer, I stick to the numbers. All of my proposals are substantiated by numbers. In the case of taking the money from the half-cent sales tax and putting it back to the PTP, Chairman Paul Schwepp has agreed with me. He was in the editorial interview with the Miami Herald, and the Herald mentioned his name and his support of my letter to the Herald, which led to the editorial support.
Well, then why can't you and Commissioner Stephen Bovo get this passed by the county commission? Because you can have a say.
Yes,
in,
yes.
I mean, otherwise, if you're going to say that this is all Mayor Gimenez's fault, it's like the commission has no responsibility. Well, the commission legislates, and the commission is not legislating.
There's another way to do it.
But why can't you do it through the county commission?
Well, I don't think we have the votes.
Well, then.
As of Thursday's commission.
So why don't you blame the county commission?
Well,
instead of just blaming, and or if you want to blame Mayor Gimenez, blame Gimenez, but blame the county commission too.
Putting blame is not my shtick, let's say.
But you are blaming. You're blaming Mayor Gimenez.
But I'm telling you, there's another way to do it. The CITT, that board that manages the people's transportation money, the half-cent sales tax, can, by majority vote, ask for this money, disengage from the county operations, and ask for the money back. And then we can only override them by a two-thirds vote. I guarantee you, if the CITT does that, and I've sent a letter to them asking them to do that, that I will guarantee you that I'll get the 5 votes necessary to make sure that their decision is not overridden by my county commission. Because I'll go on the air again, and I'll find the money somewhere. I don't have all that much money left in my pack after this ad buy that I'm doing, but I'll find the money, or I'll do it with my upcoming campaign for re-election, assuming I stay as a candidate.
Some people say that you're not running for re-election. Some people say that you're really running for Miami-Dade County Mayor.
To a great extent, this period between now and the end of September, and then an event that I have October 10, is a test period for me to see if we can get things moving. If I can't get things moving as a legislator, as one of 13 commissioners, I might have to consider running to be the chief executive of the county. I also have to check with my wife, by the way. She's not all that pleased about this whole idea. So.
I can only imagine that conversation. Commissioner,
I don't think she's seen the ads yet.
I don't know. I
but
think
I'm
she's,
sure.
I think she's up on everything. Commissioner Xavier Suarez, thanks so much for joining us today
Thank
on
you,
Issues.
Hon.